Hi guys, welcome back to A Greater Gorgeous. Today I wanted to do a really easy summer look for you. Something that's going to be quick, that doesn't require a lot of makeup, and that's really going to look kind of fresh and not like you're totally done up for summer. I'm using all of the products that I recently put in my last blog post about my recent beauty obsessions. So you'll get to see me use all of those. And this is just something that anybody should be able to do. It's very simple, low-key, not complicated. So I hope you enjoy. Bye. I'm going to start off with a primer today, even though I don't normally use a primer. This is the Benefit Stay Flawless 15-Hour Primer. And the reason I'm using this is because it is summertime, skin gets greasy, you know, being out in the sun, you get sweaty, and I just really want my makeup to last all day. So then I'm going to go in with MAC Face and Body Foundation in the color C1, which is the lightest color they have, so sad. And I'm using this foundation because it's a sheer foundation, but it's buildable, which means that that first layer that you put on there is not going to be a ton of coverage. It'll be a little bit of coverage, but kind of more like a tinted moisturizer. But it's going to go on there invisibly. You're not going to be able to see the makeup on your skin. And then you can go in, which I'm going to do, and do another layer and another layer if you want to sort of build up that coverage without having really thick, cakey makeup on. So here I am doing a second layer just to get a little more coverage because I just personally like that. Next, I'm going to use Benefit Stay Don't Stray Eye Primer. This is meant for both under your eyes and on your eyelid. And I love this mostly for concealer priming. That's my biggest issue, is that my concealer moves throughout the day. So I always use this under my eyes these days to help my concealer stay put. And the nice thing is it's got some coverage, so it adds just a little boost to whatever my concealer can do. Next up, I'm gonna go in with the MAC Painterly Paint Pot. This is basically a cream eyeshadow, but it's a matte color, and it's really just gonna even out my eyelids, and it's gonna set to really be a primer for the eyeshadow that I'm gonna put on today. While I let that set, I'm gonna go in with my Anastasia Brow Powder Duo and do my brows. I, in the summertime, really like to do the powder first, and the reason for that is that I really want a softer, more natural look. I find that if I go in with the pencil first, a lot of times it can end up looking too bold and too sharp, and so I really want something softer. So I'm going in with the powder first, filling in my brows as best I can with the powder, and then I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Brow Wiz in Ash Blonde and really sort of define my brows a little bit more. So I'm going to sort of take that line underneath and sharpen it up a little bit. And really I'm going to fill in that inner corner of my brow, which the brow brush is not really as good at with the brow powder because I don't have as much hair there. Next, I'm going to use the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. And I'm going to use this as my eyeshadow. This is all I'm going to do on my eyes. This is really just to give them a little bit of contour and a little bit of depth. But this is the extent of it, because we don't want really overdone eyes for summertime. And this is why I say this look is so simple for anybody. I'm using a Sigma E35 tapered blending brush. And I'm really just putting that in the crease, kind of swiping it back and forth and a little bit in the corner. The more you blend, the better this is going to look. I'm going in sort of with several layers, and every layer deepens that crease color. And I'm just blending back and forth and back and forth so I don't look like I've got a bunch of eyeshadow in my crease. This is really going to add some depth without being overdone. Next up, I'm going to go in with Urban Decay's 24/7 Glide-On Eye Pencil. This is the double-ended pencil that they make to go with the Naked Basics palette. On one side is the color Crave, and that's the color I'm using to tightline my eyelashes right now. The other end is a really pearly white color that's perfect for highlighting right under your brow. You can stop with the tight lining here and not go any further, and this look will still look great, but I'm gonna do a little bit of eyelining on the top. Every once in a while, I only do the outside corner and I blend it, and I don't line the inside corner, but today I'm going for it and doing the whole thing. I'm then going in with the Real Techniques accent brush, and blending that eyeliner out. The thing that this will do is it will give your eyeliner staying power, but I'm really also going in to extend that line out and flick it out just a little bit. This I personally like for my eye shape and the look that I'm going for with my eyes. You don't have to do this part, but I prefer having a little flick to the hard edge on the outside, and the accent brush really helps me do that. Next up, I'm going in with Lash Primer. This is by Tarte. I don't know why I've been using this so much these days. I have had this for a really long time, and I don't really use it that much, but lately I've been using it every day with my mascara, and I really just feel like it adds to the plumpness of my mascara. This is my new mascara that I seriously love, and it was in my recent Beauty Obsessions blog post that I just did. I have been going in with it every single day. You know me and mascara, I don't use the same mascaras over and over and over again. I have a big cup and I just pick one day to day based on what I feel like. This is the one that I've been using every single day, and it's just really plumped up my lashes, and I think it just performs so well. I mean, I guess that's what you get when you pay $30 for mascara. Next up is concealer. I'm using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, and I'm dabbing this on under my eyes in sort of a highlighting effect. I'm going to go down around my nose as well because I definitely get some redness around my nose. Then I'm going to go in and blend with a Beauty Blender sponge. You can really do your concealer however works best for you. You don't have to put as much on as I do. You don't have to put it on where I do. You can stick to just under your eyes. You can stick to just around your nose. You can skip concealer altogether if you are blessed with no under eye circles. But really just do what works best for you. And I just really personally love the Beauty Blender for blending my concealer. So I always dampen it first, hold it under the water and squeeze it until it kind of grows in size, and then squeeze it out in a towel to get that excess moisture, and that'll give you an even softer blend. Now I'm just going in and concealing any extra spots I have and concealing my chin area because that can get a little bit red as well. I'm just making sure that everything looks kind of even. Next up, I'm going to set it with a NARS Translucent Setting Powder. This is a pressed powder. I think they might have a loose powder as well if you want it, but this is really to make sure that all of my makeup stays in place. Not everybody needs this. If you have dry skin, you may not need it. I have dry skin, but my skin still overproduces oil a little bit throughout the day, so I put this on to just make sure that my makeup really doesn't need to be touched up, and that's what I love about it. Now, after doing mascara on my lower lashes, I'm going to go in with that Milk Chocolate Soleil bronzer again. I'm using a duo fiber brush to very lightly dust it on my cheeks. Don't just go in there and swipe it all over the place with a ton of product. You really want to make sure that you build this product. And honestly, it doesn't matter what bronzer it is, whether it's the Too Faced Milk Chocolate bronzer, whether it's some other bronzer, if it's a drugstore bronzer, other high-end bronzer. You never want to just go in and try and get it all done with one application. The most natural way to do it is to really build it up and blend it. So the thing you want to do with bronzer is really put it where the sun would tan you. So we're not contouring with this, we're bronzing. We're making it look like I've been out in the sun. So go in on the tops of your cheekbones and across your nose, and you want to go in on your forehead, on the outsides of your forehead, and then across your hairline at the top. I'm going to go in on my chin a little bit as well, and then just so that I don't look like I'm just fading into pale skin, I'm going to put a little bit under my jawline as well. Not quite as much as I put everywhere else. It's very important to take your time with this application because building it up is really what's going to make it look more natural rather than trying to do it all at once. And that's why I showed you this whole application without cutting it, so you could see how many times I go in and just kind of build it up. Next up is blush, and this is a recent discovery of mine, Revlon Pink Blush. And I think that this is just a very light, natural looking blush, and it's Oh Baby Pink. And I love it just to add a little bit of glow after doing that bronzer application. And I'm gonna blend that in as well just to keep it looking natural. Next up, I'm gonna use the Mally Beauty palette that I put in my blog post. Today I'm only going to use the highlighting color, and I'm just going to dust that on top of my cheekbones just to give it a little bit of highlight. Right now, this is my favorite highlighter because it doesn't look like you've got highlighter on your face, but it just gives you a really pretty glow. I'm setting my eyebrows with Anastasia Brow Gel, and this is just to make sure that they don't move anywhere. I'm going in with my favorite lipstick, my favorite natural nude lipstick, which is Maybelline Lipstick in Warm Me Up, and then I'm going in with Almay Liquid Lip Balm in the color Rosy Lip just to give it a little bit of shine and to sort of make it a little more nude and a little less pink. Now you could stop there if you want to
and you'll totally look done, but I'm kind of obsessed with these false lashes these days, so I am going to go for it. These are the Ardell 318 Accent Lashes. I love them because they're just really easy to apply since they're just a half set of lashes. They look super natural, except that they sort of flare your lashes out a little bit, and they're really comfortable. A lot of times I forget that I even have them on, and I start to take off my eye makeup while they're still there, and that's when I figure out that they're still there. So I'm going to apply these just to give it a little bit of glam because, like I said, I'm kind of obsessed with these right now. You certainly don't have to do this, but that, for me, is the finished look. And I hope that you feel like this is something you can accomplish at home. I hope you guys are having an awesome day and a wonderful summer, and I will see you soon. Bye.